The next station is Theydon Bois. Please mind the gap between the train and the platform.
Departed Theydon Bois station, and today I'm heading to walk along a section of Roman Road at Hobbs Cross. Somebody came up to me after the screening of London Overground at the Genesis and told me that this section of Roman Road was here, and then they sent me the coordinates on the OS map, and so I'm going to head out there now. It's a beautiful, clear autumn afternoon, about 1:30, and there's another version of this walk which doesn't go via Hobbs Cross but takes a more direct route between Theydon Bois and Epping. It's fantastic. I did it one September with my youngest son, and it's a really beautiful walk, that is. Great views, looking towards Epping. I think that's the M25 down there, which I will cross further around, but first I've got to go underneath the M11. Abandoned bike in the hedgerow, always a bad sign. Look at these amazing plants. I wonder what these are. If anyone knows, please leave a comment. Essex really is the capital of fly tipping, and this has got to be up there for the award of fly tip of the year. I mean, what the hell is going on here? Look like a house exploded. It's almost like that armchair has been set up to enjoy the view rather than just being dumped here. A tip with a view rather than a room with a view. These edgeland landscapes around the fringes of London really do throw up some fascinating vistas. I mean, look at this field here, that fly tip, a bit of discarded farm machinery, this hunk of rusting metal something. I don't know what that is. Anyone know? Please let me know below. All these kind of bricks, discarded rubble. These peculiar plants. It's all going on out here, around the fringes of London. And there's the ever-present drone of the intersecting motorways, the M11 and the M25, bisected by a Roman road and even older trackways. I mean, astonishing landscape, a world of wonder. An abandoned caravan next to this peculiar kind of modern looking building. I suppose it must be like a barn or something. This is on the footpath, so I have to go through here. So actually that looks like it could be like a chicken coop. Or certainly for keeping animals. Wow, this is a really lovely straight green track. Kind of footpaths you dream about. Mistakes sometimes work in your favour, I suppose. This is a slightly different route to what I had initially planned, and so I'm actually going over the M11 rather than under it, which I would have been passing under it along a footpath down there somewhere. But so a slight change of plan, but I think this is a slightly more interesting route, actually. Look at all the pigeons, or they could actually be seagulls, come to think of it, following that tractor, ploughing the field. I think they are seagulls. Well, you can hear them. This is another example of fantastic open countryside. Just 20 minutes on the central line from Stratford. The Stratford mega city nightmare. And here you have the kind of bucolic dream of old Albion. Well, that's stretching a point, I suppose, isn't it? But you know what I mean. You'll give me that one, won't you? Jack fading in the shade of that tree there. I wonder if that's a metaphor or it's just been left out in the sun. You decide. Whatever your political persuasion, you have to agree the world seems to have gone a bit nuts at the moment, doesn't it? Certainly over the last year. So it makes activities like this for me ever more important, ever more necessary. It's a more truthful and kind of essential way of interacting with the world and a way of dealing with it. It's just to take off, to abscond, to engage in fugue. That's kind of how I feel anyway. And that road there kind of almost directly leads to Hobbs Cross, passing underneath the M25 up there. But I'm gonna take a slight detour down here by All Saints Church and through a wood. Look, the Monk's Walk. Why would you not want to take? Wow. It's almost the perfect setting for early autumn. First conker of the season. Used to play that at school. Used to love playing conkers. Okay, I just walked towards the church door, I turned around to get a better shot, and look, who is buried right outside the church door here at All Saints. Also, John Crush Rogers of Savile Place, Mile End Road, died 28th, April the 28th, 1841, aged 79 years. And up here we have Elizabeth Rogers, wife of Mr. Richard Rogers of Woodford, eldest son of the above laid Richard Rogers, 11th of July 1759. It's a bit of a Rogers necropolis going on here. The different middle name reassures me slightly. My birthday is the 28th as well, but not April. Look, there's some dried flowers. Well, hello John, from John. So this is the grave of Anne Rogers here on the other side. Can't quite see the date. And of William Rogers, which was my grandfather's name. Can you see the date? 17 something. That's the tomb of the Rogerses. Here at Theydon Garnon. Can't find a date for the church, but they say on the website that it's been here for a very long time, or a Christian site will have been here for a very long time due to the proximity to the Roman road, which is very close by, and also a medieval road running to the west. Very peaceful spot. So this delightful little footpath will take me to the start of this section of the Roman road that you can walk along. So here's a little stream running south to make its confluence with the River Roding. So this now follows the course of the old Roman road between London and Great Dunmow. There you go, look at that rabbit running across the track there. There's a possibility that this is the Roman road that runs along part of Leytonstone High Road as well. And another rabbit. Particular feeling that you get when you walk an ancient road, this road being, you know, just under 2,000 years old. But a lot of the time the Romans were building along pre-existing trackways of much older ancient thoroughfares. Something really special about following these ancient tracks, these old ways. The M25 thundering overhead. Imagine some Roman soldiers wandering along here nearly 2,000 years ago. And of course, the Roman army drew its soldiers from across the empire. There would have been soldiers from all over the Middle East and Southern Europe wandering along this footpath nearly 2,000 years ago. It's quite a thought to play with, isn't it? So the old Roman road carries on along here, up to a farm, and then I reach a decision point. Classic red phone box. Real heritage item. Wonder if the phone's still working. There's Ivy in here to call lift handset. Phone maintenance. Come on. Pay phone maintenance. BT apologise. Please wait. Oh, I miss these things. Calling my mum at 2 in the morning. Yep. They say all roads lead to Rome. So if I keep going along here, eventually I should arrive in Rome. Haven't been to Rome for a few years, that'd be quite nice. Wonder how long it would take. So there's a footpath that runs up and around the edge of that wood. I think I'm going to sit on the brow of that hill and eat the rest of my sandwich. It's a lovely way to spend a Sunday afternoon. Shame my lens isn't powerful enough. But just to the left of that clump of trees, I'm trying my finger into shot there, where my finger, just above my finger, you can see the towers of the City of London in the far distance. It's an amazing view. Looking right the way back down into the city. Another anomaly of the Edgelands. We've had the fly tipping, the Roman road, we had the old phone box, and now we have this old-fashioned W.H. Smith's trailer, it looks like, dumped in this field here. That's like W.H. Smith's logo from the 80s. Fantastic. This is the continuation of the Roman road. That wood I was sat on was just sitting above it. And my guess is that it continues along the road across just back there on the way, sort of in the direction of Ongar. And now I'm going to follow the path here along the edge of this field. I've now turned in the direction of Epping. Sort of super posh designer glass houses going up in this field here, and that's the view they're going to have from their box house, their glass box house. Not bad. My guess this will be for like city people, people working in finance in Canary Wharf in the City of London. Could be completely wrong, I imagine. This walk is scored by the incessant planes going into North Weald Aerodrome or airfield. It's the last hour now up to sunset. Best time of any walk. Thanks for coming on this walk with me. I really do feel like I am walking with the people who are going to watch the video. So, thanks. It's really lovely to have your company on these walks. It's much appreciated. What is that? What the fuck is that? Do you know what? I've not seen a single other walker today. There's one guy right near Theydon Bois Station with his dog, and that has been it. Just a few cyclists. The M11 streaming east out of London. Doesn't look like we're going to get a nice sunset. It's suddenly become quite cloudy. It's a shame. This is the path over the M11. Very cute looking pub, the Theydon Oak. If there was more daylight, I'd go in there, but otherwise when I come out it'll be pitch black. Fantastic names. Fiddler's Hamlet, Toot Hill. So this path here, basically taking me towards Epping Station, is part of the Essex Way. It's a long distance footpath. Just goes from Epping Station. I think it finishes somewhere near Harwich on the east coast. It's about, I think it's 60 something miles, 60 odd miles, maybe 70 miles. I'd quite like to do it one day. Let's do a part of it now. This is the final footpath. It's just as well, as you can tell, it's quite gloomy now. No sunset today, which is a real shame. So this little bit of the Essex Way into Epping Station. Imagine you're doing this at the end of a 5-day walk. Wow. Imagine you're doing this at the beginning of a 5-day walk.